This is also a very interesting concept of learned stupidity, especially in the SCRTs and diets. Today in the Government of India, they're talking about formulating a policy on early childhood education, the Department of Women and Child Development. Because the word education comes into it, so there is a little kind of a hesitation there, and they are in touch with the Education Ministry of Human Resource Development that they want to get support from them to be able to really implement this policy because of the educational component. And the ministry is saying, okay, we'll get the SCRTs and diets to do it. But where is the capacity in the SCRTs and diets also to do it? So that also needs to be built. NGOs have very few for children's development. And what we found was that there is an increase. Maybe it was the other one. There is an increase in terms of the finances, funding going to for children's programs, but largely it is being absorbed by the elementary education. Maybe rightly so, because elementary education needs it, but then there should be some coming to early childhood as well. So it is whatever increase we see is all about elementary education, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, and now right to education, which is taking up most of the funding. Monitoring and evaluation, I've already said, is very weak. And one of the problems with preschool education is that there are no tangible indicators. If you see in the ICDS system, the only indicator that is being used is number of children enrolled. And we know what enrollment is all about. Last one, this is about the what is the way, I mean, there are lots of intervention. This is what concerns me a lot, that you know there are lots of NGOs working in this field. There are some good initiatives happening with the government also, but none of these get sustained. And why do they not get sustained? What is the issue there? And to my mind, the issue is basically because there is not enough engagement with the stakeholders, particularly with the parents and communities, because they don't see the value and the priority, and they don't even have an understanding of what they should demand, because their notion of preschool education is school. So I think somewhere there is a lot of need to do advocacy at the various levels to be able to really, because there is a lot of talk in seminars about regulation. Even in the policy that is being formulated for early childhood education, the ministry is talking about regulation, that there will be should be some system. But rather than having a system of regulation of the supply provisions, I think if the right demand is created, it will automatically regulate the supply. So somewhere, I think all of us in our respective roles need to work together to be able to create that right kind of demand for the right kind of preschool education or early childhood education, so that we are able to have a more sustained benefit, get across a more sustained benefit to the children who are all our primary concern. Thank you.